Less than 8 weeks are left before the deadline runs out. 8 weeks in which, according to General Amin, 65,000 Asians must leave Uganda. So far, only a handful have gone. The rest spend day after day waiting in queue after queue. They queue for tickets. They queue for permits. They queue at ministries. They queue at the bank. But still, they can't get out. In Kampala, the Asians are dazed and frustrated. The new threat that if they fail to leave before the deadline, they'll be sent into concentration camps run by the army, turns anxiety into fear.
Are you worried? Some people seem worried here about the situation actually in Uganda.
Well, definitely. You see, that at moment, as you can see, every day you get a bloody new forms to fill it up. And every day new law, you know, and new rules. And you don't know what to do next. You go East African Airways, they give you a form to get a ticket. Then you fill that up, you go to Bank of Uganda, you go to other, you don't know what to do. Just run up and down, just looking for the forms, that's all.
How long do you think it'll be before you're able to get out?
Well, we don't know ourselves yet. We are still, as you can see, standing in a queue. When they're going to give us a form, we don't know. And after issuing these forms, what they're going to do also, we don't know.
Why do you think the president is doing this?
Well, he might be a madman or something like that.
Everybody depends on luck, but they are mostly worried more than they require.
More than terrified?
More than terrified, no.
Are you?
Everybody, not myself. Everybody in this line also.
Can I ask you how you feel at the moment here?
Well, the opinion is the same. Hmm? Everybody is, you know, the opinion is the same.
Which is what?
Well, everybody is fearing, you see, the present situation here.
What
in
are you frightened of particularly?
Particularly, you can't say the situation at the moment, what things may happen in the future.
At the moment, our main worry is to kind of get out of this country safely. We are not even worried about our belongings or our things. But what we would like is personal safety. There have been so many queues and so many forms to be filled up, and life is being made very difficult. There is no outlet. The trains stop the bookings. I mean, do not accept bookings of Asians. There's no seats available in any plane. You cannot go to a neighboring country. So we are, in fact, kind of isolated or kept in this place by force. Although he has given us a deadline, I don't see how we will be able to get out within the deadline.
And what will happen? Is that what you're worried about?
Yes, because a statement has been made that those who stay here after the deadline will be sitting on fire. So we do not know what that sitting on fire really means.
The signs of imminent departure are now evident. Stocks are running down, not to be replaced. Flats and houses are bare. Furniture has been stored, sold or given away. Shops and businesses are for sale. Business activity in streets in the centre of Kampala is nearly at a standstill. Their owners are waiting to get out. The Asians live on rumour and in fear. The government radio tells them that they're enemies of Uganda and that the security forces are watching them. Only a few dare to be seen for long in the company of foreigners. This Asian businessman came to Uganda 30 years ago. Like those who had come before him, he's thrived.
What did you like about Uganda? Why did you want to come to Uganda and not stay in India?
Very easy earning. Main point is that. And easy life. At most, that is, you know that Uganda is no cold, no hot, no rain. Every season is very nice.
Have you had a very easy life here?
Very easy life, easy earning. And the people of Uganda are not bad. Africans are very cooperative.
Easy earning in what way?
While we import goods from London, we get 5 shillings a yard, we sell 7 shillings, we get that price, no trouble. We keep in our shop and we sell it, people taking. Very easy earning.
A lot of Asians have servants. Do you have servants? Did you have servants
yes,
before?
Yes, we had, three, four servants we were keeping. We had big shop.
And they were Africans?
Yes, also Africans also.
Why is it, do you think, that in this country the Asians have been and still are so successful?
Because the Africans, they didn't know the business. How can they? To run the business or to run the factories without brain, nobody can do it. How they can?
Can you imagine what England... You haven't been to England before.
No, I had not gone to England. My son, there are.
Can you imagine what England will be like?
Yes, I can imagine just as Bombay, bigger than Bombay. Very nice city, maybe. Tomorrow, after tomorrow, I will see it.
But, like thousands of others, he has yet to see England. On the day before he was due to leave last week, he learnt that all charter flights had been cancelled. At Entebbe Airport, the airlift has yet to begin. On the edge of the tarmac lie the forlorn remnants of the good life. Soaked by storms and bleached in the sun, this Asian baggage has waited here for 2, 3, and sometimes 4 weeks. It'll soon be ruined. With the simple order, get out, the Asian has been humbled, stripped, and revealed to the African as a mere mortal. Until now, the Asian community, 80,000 out of a population of 10 million, has controlled Uganda's economy. They own nearly all the large shops and businesses. They do all the importing and exporting. They own the factories. They man the skilled posts. They're the doctors, the clerks, the accountants. In the 70 years since Britain brought them into East Africa, they've managed, quite simply, to take over the economy of Uganda. It is the Asians who have the large cars. The Africans drive jalopies, go by bus or on foot. The Asian elite live Western, sophisticated lives. They enjoy the recreation of the affluent. They earn £5, £10, £20,000 a year. They reside in expensive houses and retain a cluster of servants. The Golf Club, an imperial legacy, now admits Asians as well as Europeans. The Africans are their caddies. It is a role to which the African has long been accustomed, but it's now an African who's bringing the serene progress of the Asian lives to an abrupt end. The rich Asians, if they have British passports, are waiting to be hustled out along with the rest. If the Africans rejoice, they do so in private. The Asians' religion, their culture, makes contact with Africans, except in the most superficial way, almost impossible. Amin is obsessed by Asian exclusivity. Africans and Asians live in two different worlds. But now, the government is openly trying to stir up latent resentment against the Asians. Amin deeply resents the fact that Asians won't marry Africans, the fact that they remain a race apart. In the poorer, mixed areas of Kampala, the Asians, small shopkeepers and businessmen, are always richer than the Africans. This man is typical of thousands of Asians in Uganda. His business employs 4 Africans and provides him with a comfortable income. It allows him to employ a houseboy, an African. The Africans are the servants in every Asian household. They earn about £2 a week, providing their masters with the good life. Only since the general started intensifying his pressure on the Asians are the cracks beginning to show. There is resentment and envy. And though they're leaving behind their businesses, their house and their money, nearly all the Asians are longing to go. This family was about to leave for England when it heard that its flight had been cancelled by the government. As the head of the family was frightened to speak openly in front of Africans for fear of informers, we were forced to go to the outskirts of Kampala to talk.
How will you feel about leaving?
Pretty sad. I've lived all my life here, you know, and it's a beautiful country. And I really feel sad when I leave, you know. Because I used to think it's my own country, you know, at one time. Because I'm born here.
Now?
Well, now I don't have any feelings for it, you know. Because most of my kinsmen aren't being treated, you know, in the right way, you know. They're being treated in a very inhuman way, I should say. And we've been asked to quit the country in 90 days, you know. But things, the problems the Uganda government is sort of giving us is, you know, are really bad, you know.
Tell me, why are the Asian people here now so frightened that you meet?
Probably they think that there's going to be some kind of a coup or a war or something, you know, pretty soon. And if something happens to the president one of these days, maybe the army will blame the Asians, you know. And they think that the Asians will be the first one to get slaughtered.
Are they frightened of the army particularly?
Yeah.
Why the army so much?
Well, for the last few years that the army has been in power, you know, it has been really, really hostile and wild, you know. Every time there's something, they just come out of the barracks, raid houses, harass people, just beat them up, you know, things like these.
Do you understand why he told the Asians they had to get out?
Probably because he thinks that they've been taking a lot of money out of the country. And he thinks mostly the Africans are out of business, you know, because of the Asians here in Uganda. Which I don't think is true. Frankly speaking, the Africans have never worked all that hard to attain the standard, you know.
What do you think of the Africans here?
They're okay, you know, they're not too bad, but some of them, you know, some of them are really, really nasty.
In what way? Really nasty.
They don't have any respect, you know, for us Asians, you know. They can just talk to us like, you know, they're talking to their houseboy or somebody, you know. And abuse people on the roadside and this and that.
Are you aware of characteristics that are different in the personalities of yourself compared with an African or contrasted with an African?
In a lot of ways, yeah.
What kind of ways?
Yeah, like, I would only sort of spend, I mean, I would spend, you know, under my budget. Whereas I've seen some Africans, you know, my good friends, you know, some of my good African friends, so they make 1,000 shillings a month. But by the 15th of the month, they would have spent all their money and then come and borrow money from me, you know, for the rest of the month, you know.
What do you think of that?
I think that's quite bad, actually. I mean, they should always try to control their expenses, you know. I mean, I have never been a rich man all my life. When my dad died, I was only left 300 shillings in the bank, you know. But I started with those 300 shillings and I worked my way through, you know. And I've always sort of kept one thing in mind, you know, that I must spend under my budget. And this way I've been kind of successful.
What are the qualities, do you think, that the Asians will be bringing to Britain? I mean, what do you think are the most important qualities they've got?
They've got very good business qualities, mainly. Like, they might start owning a lot of properties in the UK, you know, in the near future. Because Asians have always liked to own properties, you know, like buildings and houses, you know. They're not interested in luxuries of the world, actually. Because they think in the long run, properties and businesses do pay a lot.
And the Africans?
Well, Africans, I think they live their life every day, you know, sort of earn 10 shillings today and spend maybe 10, you know, or maybe spend 11, 10 from his own pocket and one from somebody else's pocket.
Only a mile from the commercial heart of Kampala, the standpoint is very different. From here, the Africans look up at, but hardly take part in, the economic life of Uganda. Only 3% of Uganda's 10 million Africans are in regular work. The other 9.5 million merely subsist. For the moment, the economic war, the political crisis that hangs over their country, leaves them untouched. Because Uganda is fertile and underpopulated, because most families own a plot of land, no Africans starve. But they hardly prosper. Even the Africans in regular work earn a bare £8 or £10 a month. The lowest paid Asians earn 3 or 4 times that. It's hardly surprising that some of them are now responding to the propaganda of the government radio.
I want to ask you, what do you think of the decision to expel the Asians from Uganda?
Anyway, leave that one. Leave that one.
Okay. Do you don't want to tell me why?
Where are you from?
From England.
From England?
Yes.
Get me your passport.
I have got it in my car.
Get it.
Hmm?
Get it.
I can't get it now because I'm walking around the streets talking to people.
No. Hello?
Are you unhappy?
Stop that one.
Hmm?
Stop that one.
Why do we have to stop?
Don't take anything.
Why? Can you explain why?
No. Yes, I'm going to explain.
Please.
You remove this one from me.
Yes,
remove
okay, it. I'll move it there.
Yeah.
Can you explain?
Yes. I would be very pleased to see your good passport.
We've got passports. We have to have passports.
Anyway, when did we enter here?
We entered here about a week ago.
Huh?
About a week ago.
About a week ago. Now...
Can I talk to you, please?
That is none of my business.
It is none of your business. I see.
You go with him first.
I'm just telling you the truth.
Okay.
I would like to see the passport.
Are you an official?
Anyway, don't ask me about that one.
Tell me, what do you think about the fact that the British Asians are leaving?
Actually, that's a bit of a difficult question for me. You mean my attitude about the...
Yes, your attitude.
Going? Yeah. Anyway, it's good. It's good for them to go.
Why?
They have sacked us enough.
Will you be taking over their businesses?
Yes, according to the government's help.
What do you think about the Asians?
I want them to go.
You want them to go?
Oh, yes.
Why is that?
They kicked us.
What do you think of President Amin's decision to ask the British Asians to tell the British Asians to leave Uganda?
I don't think I would have any comment about that.
Why?
I just don't feel free to say anything about it.
Do you think it is right that the Asians should go?
What should I say? Well, it all depends.
On what?
On what the president feels about it.
What do you think?
The same thing. I don't want a photo.
Okay. Okay.
It doesn't want, eh?
I like Asians.
What?
I like them.
You like Asians?
Yeah.
Are you sorry they're going?
Yeah, I'm sorry, because I like them. They can give us money in this market here. We are carrying for them baskets, you know? And they're giving us 5 shillings. That's why I like them.
What do you think about the Asians leaving Uganda?
And they should go.
They should go?
Yeah.
Uganda's only daily newspaper, The Argus, is dedicated to the support of General Amin. It offers no criticism of the military dictatorship it fears to offend. The Argus staff follow their leader's line.
You know, from experience, we've discovered that Asians are very, very shrewd. And they've been exploiting this country for a very, very long time. So if the president gave them a very long time, they would have really succeeded in taking everything from this country.
Do you have no qualms at all about the decision to tell people to get out in 90 days?
Not at all. Why should I? I think President Amin is in the right direction.
But what about the queues of extremely worried and quite often frightened Asians saying, we don't know where we're going, we don't know what's going to happen to us, why can't we get out of the country, our papers are being held, that kind of thing. Doesn't that worry you at all?
But for people who have been living with Asians, we know how much they can panic, you know, when it's a minor thing. And that's why you expected this. In fact, they are doing it better. We expected much more confusion than there is today.
Why?
Because they are known as the most panicky people in the world. If you've been living with these people, you would, you know, just know that this is the right thing they're doing. There is no cause to worry at all.
The Asians say that the reason why that they dominate the economy is because they're actually better businessmen, that they're better at doing those kind of things than the Africans are. Willie?
No, it isn't. The fact is that the Africans were deprived of opportunities to get into trade. That's the whole point behind this. Rebecca. And again, going back to this question of racialism, I think in the case of Uganda, this does not arise. Because if you were to go back, I mean, to the coming of the Indians here, they were just imported by the British when they were constructing the railway line from Mombasa to Uganda, see, in the first place. So these people belonged to the British, not Uganda. And when Britain was leaving, when the British government was leaving, then they left their people behind, giving just a headache.
Another view would be that, in fact, they've sustained the economy, and now that they're going, the economy is going to collapse.
You know, it will collapse for a short time, but I'm sure after the teething troubles, then the economy will come up.
The Asians were gaining much from us. And you said earlier that, you know, the economy would collapse. Yeah, it will, maybe, for some time. But we are going to build up. We are ready to work hard for the country. We're not just going to sit behind and relax, leave nature take its own course.
Uganda's fragile economy is verging on collapse. If the whole business and commercial edifice of Kampala is not to crumble with the Asian exodus, if Amin is to win the economic war, then he'll need money and men. Otherwise, machinery will run down, offices and shops will close, prices will rise, and thousands of Africans will find themselves without work. At the moment, even if the men are there, with £30 million of aid suspended, the money is not. It is no wonder that the Asians tremble. When the army speaks, Uganda listens. When the army acts, there is usually bloodshed. That is rarely out of the Asians' minds. As President Amin drives them closer to panic, they seek only escape, even if it is to a hostile shore.